Hello everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Binding of Isaac, Wrath of the Lamb Edition. This game has been kicking my goddamn ass for the past few days. Let me think about what we could do. Let's try some challenges, you know? I played in the last video, if you didn't see it, I played as Samson, Kane, and Maggie, so that should give you some kind of indication of how well things went. Let's try, we tried Isaac was good today and it didn't work very well for us. Let's try Meat Forever. I assume this is going to give us a level 4 Meat Boy right off the start? Yeah, okay, cool. And we do have Curse of the Blind, or Curse of the Lost, whatever it is. Right off the bat here, so this should be interesting. Level 4 Meat Boy is one of those things, you know, generally speaking, don't seem to get too often. Remember that if these challenges seem, like, super imbalanced right now, we do not have the ability to go to any item rooms. Or treasure rooms, if you- Oh, come on! Meat Boy, get in there! What an asshole. So we kind of got to carry this, like, initial starting power through to the end of the game. Which is fine. I mean, like, starting with level 4 Meat Boy, there's definitely things that are, you know, could be worse about that. This is, like, a 4-boss-worthy item. If only he could get in there and actually do some damage. Fantastic, thank you. But, you know, that being said, that's not to say these challenges are balanced. Like, I still feel like this is probably going to be way easier than your standard Isaac run. But it also feels like this is going to be maybe the only way that I can actually beat this fucking game now, because apparently my Isaac skills are garbage. Okay, so let's just have Meat Boy do some chewing on Monstro there. Not like Monstro is really that difficult in his own right. What would make this challenge run, I think, a little bit more balanced, and I'm saying it like it's already won when it's far from that, but is maybe like... not only no item rooms, but maybe no boss loot as well. I don't know, maybe that would be too much to ask. What do we have here? Range and tiers upgrade, okay. Well, we're already packing, like, substantial power here. On the Meat Boy. Oh! Ooh. How do I deal with this? There we go, yeah, let Meat Boy take the damage. So we're already packing, like, a substantial punch in terms of damage, just as a result of having this level 4 Meat Boy, of course. We gotta take out this nub. Meat Boy! Meat Boy, come here! Choose something! Eat anything at all! Okay. So now all we gotta do is turn Isaac into a powerhouse. Or, I guess, alternatively, just turn Isaac into, like, a huge tank that can absorb a ton of damage. And things will work out for the best, I'm guessing. We can basically let Meat Boy kill everything. We just gotta be able to dodge. So I guess, like, on that note... Meat Boy, come here. Come here, buddy. On that note, flying would be fantastic, and certainly not out of the question, considering what's going on. If I know one thing about Meat Boy, that dude loves to eat spiders. He is crazy as shit. Alright, we got pretty much the same nonsense to deal with right here. I'm just gonna try to avoid these spiders. Maybe they'll jump at me eventually, and Meat Boy will be able to do what he does. Kill him in 2 bites. 2-bite brownies over here. Come on, Spider-Man. Awesome. Yeah, definitely worth a bomb to pick- Oh! Meat Boy! Forgot about that. Definitely worth a bomb to pick up the red patch. Apparently this is like, if you take damage, then you do more damage. It's kind of like a trinket version of the razor. So I guess I could make myself, do more damage just by taking some damage, but, you know, more likely what's gonna happen is that I will keep this, and then, on rooms where I get hit, like, by accident, it will make me a little bit more powerful, which is fine. I mean, it's worth a bomb to get a trinket regardless, especially since I didn't have one at that point. Wow, Skeleton Key is definitely worth going through a Cellar 2 mob trap room. We will never have to worry about keys again. I mean, we didn't really have to worry about them too much anyway, because we were just dealing with, shops, basically, because we aren't going to come across any treasure rooms. But still... The thing that would, like, the item that would put me way over the top right now, even only here on the second floor, is, the prayer card. Like, if I got the prayer card in combination with this Meat Boy, I would get, like, stacked on health. We would have no problems moving forward. Meat Boy, yes, please take out Angry Spider. Oh my god, they like, skate on the air like a majestic devil or demon. We got busy rooms here. I kind of expected the Cellar 2 to be a little bit shorter than this. Meat Boy is tearing ass. I don't even need these keys. Of course, now that I don't need keys, I will be getting them all the time. Now, if I could only get 99 keys and 99 bombs at the same time, like if I could pick up Pyro right now, which gives us 99 bombs, of course, that would be awesome. What do we got in the shop here? Steam sale for 15 cents. I would absolutely love to pick that up. Sadly, I don't think it's likely I'm going to come across a nickel anytime soon. I do have a blood bank. I know I can play this a couple times. But anyway, let's work our way over here first. We got 2 spider nubs to take out. Can't believe that one didn't actually shoot. Okay. Well, we know we can play this at least a couple of times. Maybe we'll get a nickel out of it. Oh, okay. Well, that's not as good as a nickel, because the nickel would have allowed us to get the steam sale, but the extra money, I'm not gonna bitch about that. I guess with two bombs, we will take a look for where the secret room might be. It could be here. Meat Boy, don't fuck with my bombs. Okay, and then it's likely in one of two of these situations up here. I'm gonna try this one. Lucky me, please, 6 cents. Ah, slot machine. I don't know why I'm risking it. I'm hoping to get, like, the dollar bill. Or more bombs, I guess. Whatever, let's play it. I don't play slot machines enough these days. Usually because they end up butt-fucking me like this. Come on. I haven't gotten a dollar bill in so long, like... I mean, that's one of those things, you basically have to get a dollar bill to unlock Kane. But I have gotten no such luck recently. Put 10 cents into this goddamn thing, you expect to get something. Okay, a single key, that's worthwhile. There we go, live bomb, blow yourself up. Or how about just blow yourself? And that didn't work out well for me at all. Basically lost 5 cents and got borderline nothing out of it. We'll go fight the boss, which I expect is not going to be a big problem. We got Blighted Ovum, which is like a reskin of Steven here. I do have to watch out. Oh, this Blighted Ovum actually drops creep behind it. Yeah, that's a pain in the ass. We'll just keep doing like our snake moves here to try not to get hit by the creep. I wish Meat Boy could fucking catch up. Thank you. Oh, and of course I get hit by it. Oh well. There's our HP upgrade. That's fine. We made it out of there. That was kind of difficult though. With flying, that would be like the easiest boss in the entire world. Anyway, caves part one. Act like you've been there before. I have about, 150 times probably. Definitely pick up the scent, because we do need our money to, you know, buy something worthwhile in the shop. It's weird that I'm not starting with a D6, though. You feel like, I am playing as Isaac, so I should be starting with a D6. But I suppose that's another added difficulty to the challenge run, which... I like that there's challenge runs built... Oh, Jesus, that was a really good flanking maneuver they did there. A pincer... Oh, my God! Meat Boy! Catch up to the meat... My Meat Boy needs a speed upgrade. That was horrendous. Jesus Christ, I lost like 3 hearts on this room. Alright, we'll pick up that key that's gonna be worthless for us. And continue moving along here. That was... garbage? Garbage day! Okay, these guys are dead. We got a cursed skull. I'm gonna stick with the... you know what, let's take the cursed skull. It looks cooler. Now we know the Meat Boy is worthless against these guys. Apparently. He catches them like once when they're on the prowl, and then never again. But otherwise, I'm just trying to work my way up to having full health again. Because right now, I feel like I'm in a pretty shitty situation. I have 5 heart containers, but only 2 of them are full. Which is kind of, I'm not going to say that's unforgivable, but it's not an ideal situation. By any stretch of the imagination. Alright, Meat Boy, do me a favor, come here. Follow me, buddy. Follow me, don't be scared. Don't be scared, come here. We're going to use you to destroy these human popcorns. Thank you. Yeah, just bite him on his face and or hands. Anything you can do to incapacitate him would be welcome right now. Well, he's going to be fucking useless on this room, isn't he? It's cool, you just hang back there, absorb the damage. 1 turret left. And what I was going to say is, I think it's kind of cool that these challenge runs are built into the game now, that I don't have to, like, make them up myself or, like, steal them from the comments. Live bomb, cool. Which is what I was doing before, basically, whenever I wanted an extra challenge in Isaac. But, you know, Wrath of the Lamb has proved, I think by now, Meat Boy, please. God damn it. Proved to be a worthwhile challenge in its own right. We could really use a library right now. That would be for the best, I think. Otherwise, I'm just getting my ass kicked, as has been normal over the past couple of days in Isaac. Got a couple victories and a couple colossal failures. Holy Grail would be off the charts useful right now. So let's see if we can't make that happen somehow. If only I hadn't lost 5 cents playing the slot machine on the last floor. If only I had any bombs at all with which to access the potential secret room. Come on. There we go. One down. Now the easy part is to come. The hard part's over. Pill I cannot access. Oh man, there's a nickel. Now we only need one more. Yes! So lucky. So unbelievably lucky. Okay, now life has just gotten a whole lot easier. We'll pick that up. That gives us an HP upgrade as well. I mean, we're low on health. I guess what we have to do now is get through this boss room. If we get through this boss room, everything's gonna be okay. At least, maybe. we can just hide while Meat Boy does his thing. Who we got here? We got Chubb. Okay. Chubb's fast, which is, you know, a notorious problem for Meat Boy. But we'll just keep flying around here. Yeah, keep eating the silkworms. That's what you should do. Yeah, there you go. Now, just do some chewing. Okay, I don't have spectral tears, which is making this a little bit harder than it would normally be. But it's working out okay so far. Chubb's about half dead. If only he would drop like a blood bag or something, life would be amazing. But that is impossible, I believe. Little Chubb would be cool. It would be a little extra damage that I would not complain about. But really, I just want him to drop like a couple of hearts. One heart, I'll take it. That'll do. Range upgrade, mostly worthless, whatever. Down to the next floor. Please, Caves Part 2. Of course, Catacombs 2. Well, you can't always get what you want, right? Still, I guess I can't complain about getting the ability to fly for like the 8th video in a row. If only Meat Boy had more vision than like an 8-day-old baby. Might have a better chance at murdering everything that he comes across. There's a live bomb there, which I did not expect. Back up to 99 bombs. I would love to get a bombs or key pill right now. Blood bank. Which is tempting to play, because it could, you know, high risk, high reward, could give me full health. At some point, but I don't know if I want to go down that road just yet. It's a little risky. That was close. Starting to amass a little bit of money again. Usually on these challenge runs, you want to maintain, like, as much of a bankroll as possible. Because obviously you want to visit the shops because the treasure rooms just don't exist. But that has not so far been a possibility on this run. Oh my god, the conga line! Surprisingly difficult for me to kill! Meat Boy, come here. You're trying to eat the flies that don't even take damage yet, buddy! Alright, now I will give you consent to murder these flies. Yep, okay, just keep chasing that one around. I'll open it up for you in a second, man, just relax. Cool, okay. Alright, we got Bomb Flat Fistula. Shouldn't be impossible because of my, of course, ability to fly right now. Yeah, you guys seen Rocky? Surprisingly good movie! People look down on Rocky! Don't be one of those people. Rockies after Rocky 2, yes, they get a little crazy. A little bit, you know, overly self-important, like in Rocky 4 when he defeats Ivan Drago and simultaneously, you know, takes down the Iron Curtain and destroys communism. And fascism. All the isms that are bad, really. Or at least that we consider to be bad. I'm not trying to make this a political discussion. Rocky 1, man, that is a heartfelt movie. Same Rocky 2, even. It has its heart in the right place. Alright, we got some health, which is great here. Rocky 1, probably one of the best sports movies of all time. I think it's a shame that people are always like, hey, Rocky 1. This is my best Rocky impression. It's not so good, eh? Anyway. How this turned into a discussion about Rocky, I don't know. I'll never forgive you guys for that. But anyway, let's continue onwards. You know Rocky won Best Picture, right? That shit's crazy. I mean, it is one of those years where it's considered, like, how the fuck did Rocky win Best Picture over, like, I forget what else was in that year. I think it was Taxi Driver or something. But, suffice to say, enough people thought Rocky was cool back in 1977. Or 78, I can't quite remember. To reward it with the Academy Award for Best Picture. What's this pill? Telepills. Alright, worthless. We do have the shop. We don't really have enough money to really make the shop worthwhile, but we do have 99 keys, so we might as well drop by. Maybe we'll fight greed and get some money so we can visit the shop on the next floor. No, the map is for sale. That is really good if I could just get 3 more cents, but I'm not going to hold my breath for that one. Just keep this up. We get another key. Again, good, because I just wasted one. There's really only one possible location for the secret room, so I feel like I might be okay to bust open, waste a bomb here. If Meat Boy knocked that out of the, like, effective range, I will never forgive him. Let's play this twice. You know what? Okay, there's our 15th cent. Now we'll go buy the shop, the map from the shop. I hope that doesn't come back to bite me in the ass, because we could end up fighting a fairly hard boss here. But, you know, normally the map shows you where the secret room is. There it is. Okay, cool. Yeah, you know, we will use our bomb to blow that up. And hopefully... maybe? I kind of want to play the blood bank one more time. That hurts. So they must have changed the rules for the secret room, more or less, because it used to be, like, I could predict it down to a science, basically. That was not worth it. Let's go fight the boss. We've done everything there is to do on the Catacombs Part 2 right now. Which is good. I think mixing up the location of the secret room is better. It balances the game out a little bit more. Alright, Meat Boy, this should be easy. Single target foe. Just go crazy. He often stands in the same place for a long time. So you just do that, and I will probably hang out behind some rocks for most of the fight, as long as you got it. You got it, Meat Boy? I think he's got it. Peep's just pissing himself, which is a good sign. It's usually a sign of fear in the animal kingdom. Well, that was easy. There's an HP up along with the tears up, a little bit of health, a little bit of spirit heart, and Krampus. That's good, actually. I used to hate running into Krampus. Now I actually quite enjoy it most of the time. Because that extra damage can make a big difference. And of course, single target foes are going to be super easy for us to take out. As a result of Meat Boy, Lump of Coal is a surprisingly good item. It's like a weird damage up, which I can get behind. Anyway, Meat Boy's tearing his ass up here. And there we go. There's a Lump of Coal. There's an extra bomb. So I think everything turned out for the best on that floor. Now we ourselves are pretty powerful, but we could really use a Ouija board or something. Oh, that was close. To make our shots travel through walls. But wow, I am doing a decent damage as Isaac alone here. We do only have one bomb, which scares me. Please, bombs are key. Oh, balls of steel. I read it fast. I saw the B and was like, yes, boy, son, get on my Isaac level. Predicting pills since 1994. Well, that's going to make people think that I'm only 18 years old, which is not true. I wish. Damn, I took a lot of damage there. Here's our shop, though. Let's go visit. What's up, Greed? Give me your money. Give me your money. Give me your money! He gave me his money. Okay, that's a lot, actually. If nothing else, maybe on the next floor I'll be able to buy some health, because I have been less than full for a long time, which, I don't know, kind of makes my OCD rile up a little bit. Like, I need those heart containers to be full, I need all shoes to be pointing in the north direction, it keeps the goblins away. There is more money in here, so we're up to 22 cents. Money equals power would also be super good right now. But when is it not, really, right? Like, money equals power, one of those items that is almost always worthwhile. Especially lately. What's this pill? Telepills. Why not? I am Error Room, maybe? Nope. Just asshole greeds. But oh well. We're fine. We're still doing okay for health, even though I've been taking a surprising amount of damage because I'm bad at the Binding of Isaac, apparently. Or have become bad at the Binding of Isaac again since the expansion came out. Well, you know what? We're going to have to backtrack. Bombs are key. Bombs are key. Range up. Okay, that's fine. We're going to have to backtrack anyway, so we might as well save that room for later. This room's actually kind of tricky with these asshole flies here. Blocking my shots and occasionally making it more difficult for me to dodge. Meat Boy is not doing himself any favors. Looking at getting into the Isaac Hall of Fame. Well, there's another nickel. Again. What did I mention earlier? What did I mention earlier? Oh, bombs are key. Money equals power would be awesome right now. Feel free to do some chewing, Meat Boy. That was perfect storm of enemies all coming at me at once. But I guess it's a good sign that I'm being, like, a little bit lazy with my Isaac play right now, and I'm still doing fine. I mean, I did start with a level 4 Meat Boy. So if I lose, it's entirely on me. We might as well fight the boss right now. I need a spacebar item, man. Alright, this guy can be kind of annoying. Go for the heart, Meat Boy. Aim for the heart. It's the only thing that takes damage. Meat Boy, aim for the heart. Meat Boy, aim for the heart right now. Go for the heart, buddy. It's right there. It's so juicy. You don't want to eat a man's face? That's some Florida zombie shit, man. Go for the heart. It's got all sorts of nutrients in there. And that's where the soul lives. Okay, well, that heart is dead. Okay, now we can worry about the face. Okay, now you can eat the back of the face. That's fine. Please, aim for the back of the face, meat boy. Oh, what a pile of garbage. Meat boy, you're terrible. Get on my level. At least my shots are doing fairly decent damage. Kind of feel bad for this masked dude. Like, he has basically no chance against our unrelenting firepower. It is going to take us 25 years to get through the boss battle, but that's okay. All around the mulberry bush, the pockets full of posies. Something, something, na 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 na. Pop goes the weasel. Okay, tears up. That was the worst rendition of Ring Around the Rosie. Prayer card, bitchin'. Alright, so let's just drop down to the next floor. I'll immediately take that HP upgrade. Like I said, prayer card. Super important. Again, it's a little late, but I'll take it. So we are going to be dealing with Mom on this floor. Big deal. I'm a doctor too. So we got pink bomb flies. I can't believe I took damage from that. Taking damage from brain guys is when you know that you need to step up your Isaac game. Range down. Whatever. Doesn't bother me. Secret room contains more money. Again, that's a possible double item from whatever shop we come across. And of course, knowing my luck, we won't have a shop on this floor. We'll just have a library. Going this way. Okay, I was kind of hoping, maybe not hoping, I was kind of expecting that we would run into the boss room there, but I'm glad we didn't. I'm gonna keep going to these extra rooms because I need bombs, and I guess above all else, I still need hearts, which is kind of depressing. But we will hopefully get some drops. Sadly, no. But some of those poop will drop health. Sometimes spirit hearts, sometimes regular hearts, I think. I don't know, man. We're trying it. It's a whole new Isaac era. Guess what, motherfuckers? Just try it. What are you gonna do? Yeah, suck it. Suck on my dick. I can fly. Oh, well, we can't really do anything about that, can we? You know what? I'm gonna pop the prayer card right now. And hopefully I won't get hit for 6 rooms and I'll be able to amass a heart container of my own. Immediately regret that decision. But again, like, it's no risk because, like, on the boss room, like, I'm still gonna get another charge for the prayer cards. It's not a big deal. Please, 2 spirit hearts. Oh, fuck you. Well, unlimited keys is awesome, especially considering I only had 98 remaining. There's an arcade, which could be worthwhile, actually. Arcade always contains a blood bank, and actually I have enough money to kind of, like, gamble for hearts on the slot machine and the skull dude. The Ace of Spades, I don't know what it does. Otherwise, you know what, we need the hearts, like, more than we need an item from the shop, probably. So we'll gamble until we get down to, like, 15 cents. Because at 15 cents, obviously, fantastic. No, I don't want your goddamn keys. It's so not valuable to me at all. You know, at 15 cents, that's when we would want to go to the shop and at least check out what the item is. You gotta be fucking kidding me. Alright, well, at least I didn't win. Seriously? Yeah, awesome. Can't wait to put that to good use. Bombs are fine. I'll take the bombs if I win. What I really do not want is more keys. I have 99, not to mention I have unlimited keys on this very floor. Give me some goddamn hearts. Embarrassing. There we go. Okay, I need these. Hey! Okay. That was a positive change. I paid like 10 cents for a heart so far. Definitely a good use of money. Alright, we gotta win this one too. Come on. Nope. Alright, we'll just watch where it goes. I think it was this one over here on the right. Nope. More keys. Alright, well, you know what? I can just buy hearts from the shop, so you can go fuck yourself, three-headed man, who is annoying as hell. And we will make our way down here. I mean, we gotta go this way anyway, because apparently this is where the boss resides. Oh, nice. That was close. We actually kill some of these turrets. There we go. All right, live bomb. No interest in that, obviously. A little bit of leaper action. Things are getting a little bit hairy here. Yeah, oh, thank you, Meat Boy. Did a little bit of my own work for me there. Ooh, that was close. Okay, we got our shop. We got a ladder. I can fly. I think that's all that needs to be said there. I'll pick up the spirit hearts. We could go back to the arcade and spend our money there trying to amass more hearts. Honestly, I don't have that kind of patience. I apologize. So we'll just save our prayer card and we'll use that on the next room after we finish the boss off. Assuming we do finish the boss off. In order to get another heart container for the next floor. And hopefully Mom will drop like 50 hearts or 10 spirit hearts or something. I mean, that happens all the time, right? So we'll just keep things going here. Has not been a problem so far. Meat Boy can handle himself. And otherwise, we're just gonna hang out. Alright, well, we made it to Mom, so I consider this a mild success. Even if we fail miserably from this point on. But Meat Boy, at the very least, he might not be smart enough to, like, aim at where he should be aiming to do damage. But he will do some crowd control for me. Can't believe I got hit by that anyway. Fine, yeah, do some chewing whenever you get a chance. But otherwise, yeah, just take care of the enemies that are coming after me. This has been a surprisingly easy fight so far. Mom has stopped. Oh, I was gonna say, Mom has stopped spawning enemies. Not so, says she. Alright, so we got like 40% left. So far, so good. Again, I kind of feel like this is all me. Meat Boy's just kind of tagging along for the ride, but maybe it's just because I haven't been focusing on him as much as he would like right now. He is a needy son of a bitch. There we go, there we go. That still hit me? Come on. We can just get her to step on her own eye or something. Go, and that should do it. One more. Oh, where did that explosion come from? A demand to know, mister! Okay, there we go. Down to the next floor with another heart container, but still very, very low on health overall. Well, not very, very low, but low. And but remember, this is a challenge run, so all we have to do is beat Mom's heart. And if we beat Mom's heart, the challenge run is considered complete, provided that I get in the chest. And I always get in the chest, baby. Okay, it was successful. Exactly what I was hoping for in terms of drops, because we were going to use that bomb immediately. Unless I place it in the worst possible position and then waste it. Alright, there we go. Cool, slot machine, go fuck yourself. Otherwise, we'll just continue hanging out by these rocks, basically. Letting Meat Boy do most of the dirty work. I feel like this challenge run is pretty easy. Part of the problem is I've been sucking at Isaac lately, and part of the problem is that I haven't gotten great items, like game-breaking items, although the Holy Grail is pretty damn good. But, you know, I still feel like we got a decent chance of success here, especially if we end the challenge run after the Mom's Heart boss fight, which I probably will, just to be safe at this point. I do want to get... I assume there's some kind of achievement or something, so I want to make the size of my E-penis grow by unlocking, or by defeating all of these challenges as soon as possible. Because everyone knows, even though you don't get gamer score for it, the size of your real-life penis is directly correlated to the number of achievements you have on Steam. Personally, I have to roll mine up every morning and kind of like slot it in my hip holster like a whip. And you know, I also use it as like a weapon, like a whip sometimes. And when people make me mad, I slap them in the face with my phallus. I don't know why people are acting like it's super weird. I mean, it's pretty normal. I even got it tattooed to look like a boa constrictor. I don't know where I'm going with this. Stop me if you've heard this one before. Oh, I thought I was going to take damage there, but instead I outsmarted these eyeless ooze guys. Just hanging out on top of rocks all day. Now you see me, now you don't. Fucking with their perspective like we're playing Mega Kure. Guts dude who explodes into more guts. Oh, how did I take damage there? That was so stupid. It's fine. We're doing better than usual, actually. Like, oh, we're only on the Utero Part 1 right now. For some reason, I psyched myself up to think we were on Utero Part 2. Got a telepills. I'll save that in case we need to teleport. Like, in case I needed to backtrack, because that might have saved me some time. We'll use telepills on the womb part too, probably, because why not? Maybe we'll get I Am Arrow Room. Be able to skip that last boss fight, although then we'd have to beat the cathedral, which might be risky. I don't know. Whatever. Who we got here? Headless Horseman, not a problem. Done it 100,000 times before. Meat Boy should be able to chew on the pony non-stop if he uses his goddamn brain. Which he won't. Oh, wow. Pony accidentally killed its helmet man. The only downside here is I obviously want absolutely nothing to do with the item. Because I already have the prayer card. And the ability to fly. So there's no need for it, really. We'll just amass a heart container for our next trip. We will visit the secret room and then use telepills just to see what the hell's going on with that. What the hell? That's a HP up. Oh, in full health. Oh, that's good. That's good jerky right there. All right, so we didn't really teleport very far, but that is an unbelievable boon for us right now. Everything's coming up Millhouse again. Difficult for me to imagine a situation where we don't beat Mom's heart now. Especially, that was meant to be cinematic, especially if she's right here. But it wasn't. So just ignore that and pretend I was quoting E.T. or something. I'll be right here. And I just poked you in the head, the forehead. You guys seen E.T.? It's another Best Picture nominee. Winner? Maybe? I can't remember. This has been the movie podcast featuring Northern Lion talking about movies that people don't like anymore, but I think are still okay. Wow, Meat Boy, I didn't know you could kill those guys even when they were... Tower, not a good card. I didn't know you could kill those guys even when they were, like, head down. That's an incredible power. So you know what Superman always said, with great power comes great responsibility, so... Destroy these brains, and then move on to what I expect to be the boss room. Yep, awesome. So as soon as this room is over, we will pop this prayer card just to give us, you know, a little extra health for the boss fight, because it's the last boss fight we need. Or the last room we need health for, I should say. We got Dub Glutz here. That was super easy. So there's our prayer card. We can't even see it, but oh well. And then we'll just tear this bitch a new asshole. Mom's new asshole. Sounds like a nice family film. Okay, new boy should basically be able to take care of himself here. I got 8 bombs. I should be dropping those like it's hot. It's my favorite Shaggy song. Oh, man. Okay, I'm taking too much dumb damage. I'm acting like I won it already, which is not the case. New boy, keep eating his face, please. I'm not going to make a second Florida zombie reference in one video, but... You guys, you get the sentiment behind it anyway. Alright, this is going much better now. But Meat Boy, I would still appreciate it if you could, like, even act like you're busy. Duke of Flies should go down, you know, faster than... I was gonna say Mary-Kate Olsen there, but I don't think there's precedent for that reference. Does Mary-Kate Olsen have a sex tape? Who's Mary-Kate Olsen? Alright, well that was an easy as hell boss fight. We unlocked a super fan in the basement. No idea what that does. But hey. There you go, let's check out our challenge menu. And we have 7, 6, 7, and 8 done. Awesome. Well, maybe we'll do another challenge next time. Maybe we'll do another standard run. I'm not sure. I like both of them. They're both a lot of fun. But as always, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.